All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Zoya Shchupak. She is the managing partner for Innovobot Resonance Ventures. And Zoya, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you, Steve. How are you?
Good, good, good. So you're in development of a really interesting fund, and you've raised quite a bit of capital already. You still have more to go. Maybe sort of give everyone a bit of the history behind creating this fund.
Sure. So Innovobot Resonance Ventures has been officially launched in December. We had a first close in December, but we've been working on it for a couple of years. Innovobot Resonance Ventures is a fund that is part of an ecosystem which is called Innovobot. And what makes our fund so different is that we use the platform to help us make better investment decisions and work with the companies post-investment. Our thesis, so maybe I can just talk about what the thesis of the fund is. Our thesis is based on three pillars. So the first pillar is deep tech. We believe that there is a tremendous opportunity for significant growth in deep tech in the coming decades. The second is impact. We believe in a double bottom line, and we only invest in companies that have a positive impact on the society and the environment. And the third pillar of our strategy is our PE approach to VC. We firmly believe that capital is not enough in order to help early stage companies succeed. And so this is where the Innovobot ecosystem comes into play. We have a number of operating partners who are all experts in technology. They're engineers, entrepreneurs. A lot of them have masters and PhDs. And we work with them in order to help our founders face the challenges and navigate through the difficulties of scaling an early stage company.
Zoya, is that a mistake that a lot of entrepreneurs make, is they just feel the more money to fuel, the better it is? And sometimes, I guess maybe that's not necessarily the case.
That is, yes, I could not have said it better myself. You're absolutely right. Money is really not enough, because very often what these entrepreneurs need is their expertise and the experience of building companies, and expertise in certain areas of productization, industrialization. And this is where we come in, because talent is very hard to find. You don't need to build the type of expertise that we provide is not something that a small company can have in place. And so we really intervene on an as needed basis to help them get over the particular challenges and the sequence of in the journey of building the company.
Now, I know that you're still very new, and the fund is very new, and it's still growing, but you have made an investment in at least one company. So maybe you can tell me a bit about that company and how it fit into what the criteria is that you look for.
Yes, we have made an investment in a company called Carbocrete. It's actually an investment that was made before the fund was launched. It was warehoused and then rolled into the fund. This investment really demonstrates perfectly our thesis. The company has developed a technology that produces carbon negative concrete. So as you can imagine, concrete is actually the number two polluter in the world. It accounts for 8% of greenhouse gas emissions. This company has developed a technology that not only reduces GHGs, but actually sequesters permanently CO2 in a production of concrete. So it's extremely innovative in terms of technology. There's a tremendous amount of IP in the company, totally focused on impact, because with every concrete block that a company will produce, we are actually cleaning up the planet. And the third pillar of our strategy, of our thesis, which is PE approach to VC, we have helped this company tremendously to get to where they are today, from pre-seed investment that we made a couple of years ago to helping the company attract non-dilutive funding, as well as financing from strategic investors, business model, commercialization strategy, industrial processes. So we have been accompanying the company from the very beginning. The company just had a Series A round, which was oversubscribed. So we are very, very thrilled to have partnered with Carbocrete.
In what you've described to us about the kind of companies that you look for, and one there you just made a description of as well, are there a lot of companies out there that you're looking at? Is the pipeline fairly filled right now as you look at these companies?
There is, again, a white space opportunity both because of the lack of investors in Canada that would focus on deep tech. This is quite new for Canada, but also Canada has tremendous intellectual capital. We've got so many world-class universities. There's so much research and innovation that is happening in our universities today. And the challenge we've always had is being able to bring this innovation to successful commercialization and massive scale. And that is where the opportunities lie. So we do see a really tremendous number of companies that would fit our thesis. A lot of them are still too young, but we are extremely excited about the opportunities we see coast to coast. So our thesis is really to invest across Canada, and there are opportunities in Vancouver, in Alberta, and on the East Coast as well. We've got a very healthy deal pipeline. And we've got, given our focus on deep tech and our expertise and value add, we actually have a lot of deals that are coming to us from other GPs, which we find fantastic.
Absolutely. So thank you so much. Very interesting. And we look forward to continuing to see how the fund goes as it continues to grow and those companies that you're looking at as well. So I really appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Steve.
All right. There is Zoya Shchupak. She is the managing partner for Innovobot Resonance Ventures.